So to access your Google Vault, you want to go to ediscovery.google.com. You need to be an administrator to access this, and you also need to be a user of G Suite Business. So if you're still currently on the basic plan, then you won't get access to this. You need to be on the business plan. So once you've logged into the Vault, you've got a few different options here. The first thing that we're going to do is we're actually going to set up our retention policy. Our retention policy is basically we choose how long Google is going to keep the data for us. Now, I choose to keep everything indefinitely because I never want to delete a single thing, and you get unlimited storage, so there's no reason to, unless you're the kind of company that wants to delete things after a certain period of time for privacy reasons, there should be no reason why you wouldn't keep everything indefinitely. You can see here it also keeps history from groups and also Google Meet history as well. I don't know exactly what it's going to keep from your meetings, probably not the videos, but maybe who met with who type things. Okay, so once we've created all of these retention rules, it's basically going to retain all of that data indefinitely. So then the next thing that we can do is when we want to do a search, we need to create something called a matter. Now, this is where if you were a consulting business or a legal business or an accounting firm, and they were, for example, audited, or someone's, someone's super fund is audited and you're a financial services business and you've given advice to that person, right? Now, what the super fund or the regulatory body you're gonna do is gonna say, hey, give me all of the data and all of the information related to this client, and you're gonna have to hand that over if it's been subpoenaed. And you know, if it's like criminal or legal, other legal matters, same kind of process applies as well. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna create, like, it's called a matter, but it's basically like a search that's gonna search for that data. Now, you don't have to wait for a legal event to do this kind of searching internally. You may have just, maybe a client bust up of some sort or a project that's gone to crap, and you need to go, all right, show me all the communications from all of my staff back and forth between me and this customer. And what it's gonna do is allow you to search everyone's inbox right across your business and right across your organization. So if you need to do things like put together a postmortem or a timeline on communications, then it's really, really handy for that. So I'm gonna jump into my test one here. It's basically a test matter. And if I want to hold certain data, then I can choose to hold certain data and then basically like attach it to a matter. As I said, probably don't need to use it that much day to day, but that's how we kind of like build it out there. Now, if we're just using it day to day and we just actually want to run some searches here, then all we need to do is do the search vault right up the top here. Super duper simple. And from here, let's say, for example, I want to search for all emails in and out of Angel's mailbox to anyone inside IT Genius, outside IT Genius. Hopefully there's nothing embarrassing here because I didn't give her a heads up that I was going to do this, but let's see what happens when we do the search, all right? So we're gonna search for mail data. I'm gonna say show me all data. And then we're choosing just Angel's account, even though I could choose for more broad if I wanted to. And any send time, I'm gonna hit the search button. And in seconds, it's gonna open up all of the emails back and forward to Angel's mailbox. And it looks like there's a lot coming through there because we've got heaps flowing through at the moment. That's pretty cool, all right? You can run a search there for a domain or for a keyword. Google Vault is super useful for when you need to retain and re-access data. Once you've run that search, you can then do an export either to a PST or you can export to, I believe, a CSV file as well. And that'll allow you to actually export things out. Okay, so that is Google Vault. Really, really useful technology. Again, it's not a backup. If you're interested in a G Suite backup, have a chat to our team. We have options. If you're a concierge customer of ours, you automatically get backup licenses for your G Suite, which is absolutely critical at protecting you from a ransomware attack. If you've seen CryptoLocker or ransomware viruses go around and encrypt people's hard drives, guess what? They can get into your Google Drive as well. It doesn't mean that they actually compromise Google's infrastructure, but what they do compromise is a local computer, and then that local computer synchronizes all of the compromised files into Google Drive, and you have to restore them one by one if you don't have backup software. So if you're a concierge customer of ours, just ask our team to make sure that that is enabled for your account, because we give that to our concierge customers. And if you don't yet have a backup set up for G Suite, you absolutely have to, because at least once a week we have someone who gives us a call and says, hey, all my files have been encrypted in Google Drive, can you undo it? And no, we can't undo it unless you have backup set up first. Okay, final test here. I'm gonna share with you guys one little bonus, which is absolute killer feature. I did cover this in a video a couple of weeks ago, so I won't go too much into detail on this, but this is called shared bookmarks or managed bookmarks for G Suite. And so it's important for you and your team to have a common set of applications that everyone uses, right? And this is one of the principles of larger organizations and how they manage IT. You want a standard user environment or a standard operating environment for each one of your users or team members. And what that means is a standard set of apps and, you know, they are probably all cloud apps and cloud-based websites nowadays, right, that someone accesses to get their work done. But when you're a newbie and it's your first day on the job and you're trying to work out, hey, what apps do I need to use to get my job done here in your company, then they need access to a list of apps that's going to make their lives easier. Now, you may bury that away in an onboarding document, or maybe you have it in your intranet in your Google Sites, but an even better way of doing that is to actually drop that straight into their Google Chrome. So the first day when they sign in, they've got all the links that they need access to, and that's just one more of those things that your team members don't have to ask you for and feel like a bit of a dummy when they're asking dummy questions on their first day. So what does that look like? Well, inside my Google Chrome here, I've got links. And these links are basically links that I can define from the admin panel. And these links here are basically going to be defined by the admin and automatically pushed down to everybody's Google Chrome. So how do we do that? It's sitting inside our admin panel here. It's called Chrome Managed Bookmarks. So it's in the device settings, then Chrome settings, and then it's Managed Bookmarks. And you can see here, just drop in a name and drop in a URL, and it's automatically going to push those down. Now, like with any Chrome policies, anytime you implement these, it takes, you know, 10 to 30 minutes to actually push it down to all your users. But not only do you have to wait a little bit of time for it to happen, you need to make sure that everyone is signed into Google Chrome for this to work. And so that means you jump in the top right-hand corner of your Google account. Now, I'm on a Chrome box, so you're going to see a different interface here to what you would normally see in your browser. But you want to make sure that they are signed in, not just to Google, but into the actual browser. So there's a little face that appears there in the top right-hand corner. You can't see it right now on my Chrome box, but you get the idea. I'm sure Maddie will share a screenshot if he feels like it. But you want to make sure that everyone is signed into Google Chrome for that one to work. And then the moment they sign in with their business account, boom, they're going to get all of the Chrome policies. If you're interested in more Chrome policies that are useful, then go ahead and check out our group. Probably a good time to post up the link to our group there for you guys to jump in and access that. If you are a G Suite user and you're not already a part of our G Suite community group, then please go ahead and jump in there via the link that we've got below there. That is the place for us to share our up-to-date tips on everything G Suite. This video is a bit of a summary, but in there we do nearly weekly lives where we go into depth onto topics related to G Suite and other plugins, add-ons, apps, advanced strategies, and related cloud technology and strategies for businesses that are using the Google ecosystem. So if you're interested in that, jump onto the link. It's free. You do have to apply, so just drop your details in there when you join the group, and our lovely marketing manager, Angel, we'll let you guys in. Okay, that's it for me today. Thanks so much for joining, everyone. Let me know, guys, what's your favorite tip? Drop it down below. I want to know what's your number one. Drop it in the comments, please. And we will catch you guys in the next video. I hope this has been awesome for you. If you need any help at all, drop me a PM. Just make sure you drop it into the business page, Peter Moriarty, and I'll be very happy to help you out for anything that you guys need. And of course, if you do need support from our team, then you can jump straight onto our team for support. So if you are a customer, I can see there's a number of customers who are here. If you need access to our support team, then just jump straight onto the chat there. You can message our page on Facebook, and our team will be in touch with you guys. All right, going to say big thanks, guys. Have a wonderful evening. Thank you for joining. Love it when all you guys are here live. If you are watching the replay, put a little hashtag repeat down below so I know you're on the repeat, and we will answer as many questions as possible in the comments. Till next time, ciao. Take care, guys. See ya.